four-game homestand continues as the Ducks host the Columbus Blue Jackets for the first of two regular season meetings on this beautiful Sunday evening here in Orange County. And it also is Hockey Fights Cancer Night as the hockey community comes together to raise funds and awareness in support of cancer patients and their families.
And they have to rim that puck around the boards. The advantage swings to the penalty killers. Anaheim does a real nice job.
Tabinski behind the net, tried to wrap it around it. It was rescued by Fowler, who knocked it away. Gibson did not get to the far post that time. Nice little outlet by Hampus Lindholm, right on the tape for Raquel, who churns through the neutral zone. Feeds it over. Here's Lindholm. Quick shot, fired wide.
That's a nice looking play with Lindholm coming late, joining the rush, and the timing on the pass from Raquel was perfect.
To the Kings last night, right through the middle. Aberg puts it on left wing. And it's carried in by Hampus Lindholm. This pass to Kessler in front. Eads is robbed by Korpisalo.
Oh, nice pass. Nice little play. Lindholm first on the rush. And then Kessler spotting Eads.
On December the 5th that I just mentioned in Columbus. Here's Artemi Panarin. Moves the puck ahead. And Anthony Duclair tries to cut in off right wing. Right through the crease. And Panarin, there's Werenski. Way up. Got the rebound. And Gibson with a sprawling save to keep us scoreless. Montour pinches. He and Boone Jenner slapping away at it. Still in their feet. Montour dug it out in front. Alone is Aberg. He put it through the legs of Korpisalo, but it went through the crease instead of into the net.
Boy, he had so much space to walk that puck around the goaltender.
Marcus Hannikainen keeps it moving, and now the cycle ongoing, and it's knocked away. And Sherwood lobs it into the Columbus zone. He gets to it, backhands it right on. Korpisalo made the stop. Looks up, saucers it over off the stick of Henrique, who got back on the back check. And now Sherwood up with a 3-on-2 of the Ducks. Montour joins the rush with Eaves. Eaves pulls it in. Save Korpisalo, and again he left the rebound laying around. 70 points in all of his first three NHL seasons. That's a commodity that a lot of teams would be interested in as this scoreless first period comes to a close. Goes wide, and Ducks, boy, if they could have gotten to that around the boards, might have had numbers. Instead, it's stolen by Larson, who steps up in the neutral zone. Trying to pull it into the middle. Silverberg got it to Henry, cutting from a sharp angle. It was poked off his stick.
Yeah, Werenski at the very last second able to get in there and get a poke at that puck.
Brings it high in the zone. Nice look. He got it across. Ripping it is Walensky, and that shot turned away by Korpisalo, and a fat rebound that again Anaheim gets to. Henrique again feeds Walensky, walks the line, pulls it in. A wrist shot deflected. Korpisalo finds it. Well, that was a nice looking play as Ricard Raquel got the redirect.
Yeah.
Played professionally in the National Basketball Association. That's where he gets that size. Native of Arlington, Texas. Off the end boards. Aberg gets to it, and a good recovery by Korpisalo.
Yeah, you're right. It sure was. Because that was a generous bounce. That came right to Pontus Aberg. Aberg, boy, he's been dangerous. He's had his opportunities in this game again.
On the wing, Walensky rims it around. The penalty is over. Out of the box, Pierre-Luc Dubois. And the Jackets full strength. He'll get the drop pass from Jenner. Pull it in and score! So the Jackets get a big penalty kill. Dubois jumps out of the box, takes the drop pass from Jenner, and he beat Gibson 5-hole.
But I think he screens John Gibson a little bit. And this is a quick shot. Beats Gibson through the 5-hole. He does not pick up the release of the shot by Pierre-Luc Dubois. What a game it has been for him.
But now it's Brandon Montour. Anaheim will have a short 18-second power play in another 20 seconds. Raquel with speed pulls it in. And he's hooked. They score! Fowler found it. And he has his first of the year.
Fowler just kind of knows he has to elevate that puck, and that's a big goal 4-on-4 for Anaheim.
In the hands of Ricard Raquel as he undressed Ryan Murray. That enabled him to get to the front of the net. Everyone got puck focused, including Cam Fowler, who has his first goal of the season. And Anaheim has tied it at 1 from Jesse Reese. And the Ducks have done well to be a part of that story. Big rebound here off of Korpisalo on the shot by Montour. So the Jackets' woes on the power play extended just 2 of their last 36, but they storm right back in. Dubinsky's shot sticked away by John Gibson. Seth Jones Bjorkstrand and Lundestrom go after it. It's a good centering pass by Eaves as he kept Jones at bay. Here's Fowler, high slide, scores! Off the post and in. Fowler has his second of the game.
One of the things the Ducks defense works every day with Marty Wilford on is trying to get pucks through traffic. Anthony Duclair goes out to challenge, but look at that shot by Fowler. That is perfect. Off the post and in.
We'll use the end boards. Pressure on Dubois. Montour trying to dig it free. Kicks it loose all alone in front as Atkinson's big save. And he set the rebound wide.
What a stop. What a stop by Gibson. Atkinson alone. One-on-one with Gibson, and he just beat him with that left leg.
Fires it across. Raquel and Nudavara meet at the puck. It's still in the feet of Raquel now. Pops three, kept in. Anakainen tries to give it to Nudavara, and he was tangled up as he got the shot away. Brad Shaw, when they were the top affiliate, does not agree with the call. So it's a 5-on-4, and Panarin's shot gobbled up by Gibson. In the sixth jacket power play, they win the draw. Panarin on the left wing half wall. They overload the left side of the zone. Now they work it around. Wenberg got it to Atkinson deep in his crease. Gibson has it. Back to Jones. Panarin rips it, and Gibson got a piece of it off the back glass. Larson run over, and he put it right in front. No goal. Panarin scores just as the play is whistled down.
Yeah, a delayed penalty call against the Blue Jackets, a tripping call, and the whistle is irrelevant. I mean, people often think, well, if the puck crosses the line before you hear the whistle, it's a good goal. That's not the case.
So Columbus is 0 for 6 on the power play. The Ducks are 0 for 5. Walensky was going back to the bench to change, so he'll handle this puck in the neutral zone. Cross ice, Lindholm is on his own, pulls it in. That's a graze the outside of the goal post.
That's a good looking shot by Hampus Lindholm. He does not miss that short side corner by much.
Riley Nash's shot blocked by Kessler. Centered by Dubinsky, grazed the goal, but kept in the zone by Nash, who throws it in just wide again. Rebound moving to his left. Gibson snuffs out an opportunity for Ryan Murray.
John Gibson, get back to the short side post. Nice job by Gibson.
Fowler reverses for Montour. Cogliano trying to battle it past Nudavara, who pinched. And here's a two-on-one developing as Fowler's up, rolling puck. He lets it go. And Corpusalo hangs on. Everything on the perimeter right now for the Jackets. Atkinson handles to the line for Jones. Back to Atkinson. Jones, one-timer. Save Gibson, score! Pierre-Luc Dubois has his second of the game, and it's tied with 31 seconds left. Giving up two goals or less, including tonight, in 9 of 12 appearances. But we're not done yet. Panarin just alley-oops it ahead, and Jones skates into it. In on Gibson, who stones him.
Yes, he's got the reach, and he is powerful, but boy, can he fly.
Here's Fowler, handing it off to Henrique, takes it off his skate, cuts in, got it across the board. Hat-trick game winner, Cam Fowler. The third ever hat-trick by a Duck defenseman, and in each case, the hat-trick goal was an overtime game winner. The 300th career point for Adam Henrique is the primary helper on a hat-trick game winner for Cam Fowler. The Ducks win in OT, 3-2.